This is the Triple M Saturday Rub, and as I look around the famous Saturday Rub round table, we've got some of the biggest names in the game. I'll introduce them momentarily, but coming up, Zach Tu, I understand, has got a residence here on the Saturday Rub. The Irishman is going to join us.
Surely not.
So I'm going to ask him, Bill.
Simon Goodwin.
Are you Irish?
The coach of the D's. What a year he's had. Bernie's Nuff Nuff. I'm looking forward to hearing about that. Billy's Quiz is going to be a huge part of it. Damo's got all the news. And they are the names that everyone knows very well. The King Wayne Carey is here. The great Billy Brownless.
Yes.
Bernie Vince, legend of South Australian football, and Damien Barrett. Welcome, team.
Well, why are you here, Dus?
Yeah.
That is a very good point, Damo. Yeah. Now, can I say I'm a very big supporter of a mid-year break, Duck? I know that you often just tan yourself in Bali, catch up with Ricky O and come back very relaxed.
this time of year,
I think we should legislate for everyone in the media to have a mid-year break, because we start to turn on each other, everyone cracks the shits, and it gets a little bit but our man James Brayshaw, that's why I'm here, Bill. Taken off to Noosa, and I know you did too, but now I don't laugh about lockdowns at all, Bernie, but this is amusing me slightly. JB's gone to Noosa with the beautiful Lisa and the four kids, and he is now locked down in Noosa. That amuses me, Bill.
And he doesn't give a stuff, because he doesn't care. He'll come back when lockdown's finished, doesn't matter if it's a week or two, but I was up there, right, and on the Monday, and he flew on the Monday. He walks into the Noosa Surf Club.
Oh, no.
No, he didn't.
No. He didn't walk.
He doesn't go there. He swaggered. He thought he was Conor Buddy McGregor, the way he swags in.
Mate, he does walk that way.
Oh, does he walk like that?
Then he's loose shoulders.
He's got the lovely Lisa in tow, who's about 15 years younger than him.
Beautiful Lisa.
Thanks, Bill, for having us there.
And then the four kids, Lisa's two and his two youngest ones, they're all running behind. He makes them sit on a table over here.
Oh, no.
Him and Lisa sit on this high table, sitting up there like Jackie.
And he would have asked for the wine list.
Well, straight away.
The normal public don't get.
No, the wine. Yeah.
The proper wine.
You want a beer, Jim? No, wine list. I'm sitting over there with the locals having a chat to Knackers and Spanner and
Robbo.
Yeah. And he won't come near us because him and Lisa sit up there. I don't know what they do. And you wouldn't believe it. We have dinner and, he's very happy with himself and looking around to see if anyone knows him or whatever. In the races, because we're up the TAB end.
And he can't bet.
Oh, hang on.
And he doesn't bet. We've got no idea how to
doesn't
bet.
Doesn't like betting.
He goes, Fat, give me a pineapple. I said, what for? He goes, we might have a bet. I said, I said, what do you like in this? He goes, oh, geez, the two looks good in the yard. He wouldn't know which end of the horse salutes goes up. And then he'd say things like,
Which races?
We're at Greyville, over in South Africa.
What? Zimbabwe.
On a Monday night. Just a Monday night on the Terps. And then he goes, oh, Bill, this is when punters have got no idea. And they say, Bill, let's have a quaddy on this race.
This race?
You've got to get the quaddies. Four legs. Oh, no, I meant a quinella or whatever. And then I said, what are you? Well, 50 on this one. Yeah, put it on the nose. Oh, mate.
It's like when he says, I'm going to go and have one off the wood.
Off the wood.
Yeah,
he's a big bug.
I know. And he has one and he's pissed. He can't drink. He's staggering around. He thinks he's entitled to the whole. Only walks up and down Hastings Street. Nowhere else. Won't go anywhere else in Noosaville or anything like that. He is, I know he's not here, but he is a fair dinkum flop.
He's not a man of the people in any way, shape,
and
or form.
And his dress sense. What does he wear?
Like a skater boy.
He had
the skateboard out the front. Oh, mate, he tear the globe.
And that's the issue when you've got a beautiful younger partner like Lisa, who's got a really
I must admit, I'm caught in between out of dress now.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Same reason.
Yeah, mate.
You're dressed in small-sized boys' clothing stuff.
Yeah, I've always done that, though.
Extra size.
So I'm starting to bring out. I've been doing a lot of chest work.
That's a size 16 boys.
I've started bringing out the skaterboard sort of stuff just to fit in, but it's not suiting me.
No, it's not.